Welcome to another Gimp tutorial. In this video, we're going to be learning about the Paths tool and how to use paths in Gimp. So go ahead and locate the Path tool. The icon looks like this, and the shortcut key is B to get into it. So if we're in a different tool, we can press the B key on the keyboard to quickly get into the Paths tool. When it's selected, notice our cursor changes to have this sort of look. And also we have some new options. So we have different modes. We have design mode, edit mode, and move mode. So by default, we're in design mode. If by chance you're in a different one, go ahead and click design mode. And that lets us start being able to create nodes on our path. So the most basic thing we could do is maybe create a simple line. If I left click once, we see it creates this square and a circle. The circle is the node. And if I click again, it'll draw a straight line between that circle and the next circle where I clicked. And then the square is just telling us what node is active. So if I click on this one, this node is the one I'm selecting, and I can left click and hold and move it. Or I can select this node and move it as well. And we can click again to create a third node, and then we can toggle between which one we're clicking on. If we want to close this shape off, we need to come over here into the edit mode, and then we can click where we want the line to close to, and it'll create a shape. Now it's important to remember that this right now is not a selection, and these lines are really not even on our layer. If we look at it, it's really not there. If we turn this off, we see our picture is gone, but our path is still there. So the path is not, it hasn't really drawn this yet. We can tell Inkscape to draw this, to do something either along this path, or to fill in with a certain color or pattern on the inside of the path. But by default, it's just here. It's not even a selection. And if we grab a different tool, it just disappears and it's not even there anymore. So let's go back into the path tool and let's draw a path on design mode. Let's draw a path around this triangle cone right here. And to close it off, if we click up here, it's just going to select the node like we talked about earlier. And so what we can do is go into edit mode to close it, but notice there's a shortcut. Holding the control key on the keyboard temporarily puts us into edit mode. And holding the alt key on our keyboard temporarily puts us into move mode. So if I hold down the control key, I can click here to close off this. And if I want to move it, I can hold down the alt key and then left click and drag to move this around. Well, we have some options here that you might have noticed. We have selection from path. That'll just turn this into a selection as if we had used our selection tools up here to create it. And then we can apply a change within that selection. Or we can fill path, which if we do go to fill path, it will just fill it in with whatever color is active in our foreground. In this case, it's black. I'll do Control-Z to undo that, because we can also go stroke path. And what that'll do is create a stroke, or it'll put a line along all of these lines where the path is. So if I do it right now with a line width of 16 and go stroke, it will take, again, my color, black, and create a stroke there. It's important to know that if we go to move now, if we were to move or alter or change our path, that is now etched into our image. This black line is now there. It's a part of our image. It's hard to see there in the thumbnail, but it's really there in the image. So if we turn off this layer, we see our path is still there, this path triangle, but what we drew, all the pixels in this image are not being displayed. So let's look at something useful. I'll do Control Z here a couple times. We'll get out of the tool and then back in, and now we have no paths. One thing we could use the path tool for is to create a silhouette outline of a person, like in this picture here. So when the path tool is selected and we're in design mode, we can zoom in here and we could just click. If we click, we create a node. We could click and just create lots of little nodes and lots of straight lines connecting. But what we can also do is we can left click and hold any point that we want to create an arc. And then we can drag this out, and we see we've kind of created a curved line. So that's by left-clicking and then holding and keeping that mouse clicked, and then we unclick. And then if we ever want to, we have these handles we can adjust. So if we move these around, well, that's the one that's going to be out the other side, but this will move this right here. And then we can click here, and we see that one's pretty good, but this one we need to either pull this harder or maybe change the angle a little bit. And with this particular one, since this goes clear out here, it's really not where we want. We may put this more down here, and then we can flip this a little bit, and hopefully we can create something that creates sort of a natural arc that follows this outline. And now that we've done this, so we have this right here that we've pulled clear up and out here. So when we click again down here, it's going to go up out that way and then pull it right back down. So it's important to know that if you're using those, to know how those handles affect it. And it takes a little bit of getting used to and playing with, but it's a really powerful tool. If you work with vector very much, you'll be familiar with this, with like programs like Inkscape and VectorArt. But if not, you may need to play with a little bit and get used to it. If we want to remove a node, we can just click on it and press the backspace key on our keyboard. So maybe I'll remove a couple of these ones here since I have kind of too many. It'll look too jagged. And then I can come in here on this line and I can either click on these. Well, they don't have handles yet. So to get the handles, I can left click on the line and then keep that mouse clicked and I can pull it out. And then it pulls these handles straight out. And I can use these handles to adjust a little bit and make it look kind of the way I want to. If we want to add in a node, we have to be in the edit mode. So we can either click into edit mode or we can hold down the control key on our keyboard to quickly get into there. And we can click to add, but we have to be in the edit mode. Because if we click when we're in design mode, it does what we just learned. It moves, it kind of creates an arc. So we have to be in the edit mode. Holding the control key will put us into the edit mode so that we can do that. If I want to continue adding nodes here, I have to be on the very last node before I can add more nodes in there. Does that make sense? So I'm going to quickly just go here. And when we're off the page, it doesn't matter if we're on or not. Well, I guess it would, depending on what we're going to do with this path. So I'll quickly create a very rough outline here. And then we'll see what we can do with this path. So again, to complete the path, we have to hold down the control key and then click. Now we have a completed silhouette here. We have maybe more nodes than we would need, and it might not be as smooth as it could be. But something we could do, like we've learned, we can go fill path, and we can just fill this. And oh, I had it filled with pattern because I was doing that earlier. But I can go back to solid. We can fill it with a solid. And again, it's sort of like a stamp. So if I hold down the alt key and move this, we could create a couple different stamps of this silhouette all over the image if we wanted to do that. So it's kind of an interesting way to do that. Or we can stroke the path, which will create a stroke along the path, just like it did with the triangle. We can stroke path. And there's some other options too. We can come down here to stroke with paint tool. And then we can erase along that path. We can do airbrush. We can do even like smudge or dodge burn. We can use these different tools. And what it'll do, like if we grab airbrush, for example, it'll just take the current settings of airbrush and then apply it to this stroke, which in this case, it's a very faint outline of the silhouette. So that's something kind of cool that you can do with the path tool. You can create any kind of shape and fill it and do a stroke. We can also convert this to a selection, and then we could use it, for example, to remove the background or do anything that we've done in the past with our selection tools. So there's a lot of different options here. But that's why you don't see like different shape tools. People sometimes think, well, how do I draw a triangle? And the answer to it is you just grab the path tool and draw a triangle if you want to. And then you can do whatever you want with it. You can fill it in. You can add a stroke along the outside. And so that's why there's not different shape tools like you would find in Inkscape or other programs. I think I'm going to leave this video here. It's just a basic introduction. We're going to be able to use this tool now, and so we'll use it more in the future. But I just want to get you familiar with how that works and adding nodes and making these curves and then closing off your shapes, removing. Again, you click and the backspace key for that. And so play with this. Leave your questions and comments below if you have any. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next video.